Welcome to Vision Academy. In this video, we are going to see a full current affairs of month June. Let us begin with date 1st June 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. Three women officers of Indian Air Force were part of India's first of all women group to fly a medium lift helicopter Mi-17V5. Flight Lieutenant Parul Badwaj, Flying Officer Aman Nidhi and Flight Lieutenant Hina Jaiswal were three women IAF officers flew the chopper which took off from a forward airbase in Southern Western Air Command. Keys to remember, India's first of all women crew to fly a medium lift helicopter Mi-17V5. Three women officers of Indian Air Force are Flight Lieutenant Parul Badwaj, Captain, Flying Officer Aman Nidhi, Co-pilot, and Flight Lieutenant Hina Jaiswal, Flight Engineer. Next news. Bini, a 41 years old orangutan at Odisha's Nandankanan Zoological Park, died on 29th May following a prolonged illness. She was suffering from cold and old age related respiratory tract issues. According to the treatment was going on. Keys to remember, Bini, a 41 years old orangutan, died on 29th May at Odisha's Nandankanan Zoological Park on following a prolonged illness. Next, let us see international news updates. US government removed India and Switzerland from its currency monitoring list. The monitoring list includes countries with potentially questionable foreign exchange policies and practices currency manipulation. Keys to remember, India and Switzerland were removed from US government's currency monitoring list. Next, let us see economy news updates. India secured 43rd rank in the most competitive economy across the world and Singapore topped the chart by toppling the US from the first position and Hong Kong SAR ranked 2nd place as same as last year. The US ranked 3rd in the ranking, Switzerland ranked 4th in this ranking. Keys to remember, India secured 43rd rank in the most competitive economy across the world. The list was topped by Singapore, followed by Hong Kong SAR ranked 2nd place. Next, let us see appointments. Narendra Modi, who was elected for a second term at the centre, took oath as a Prime Minister at the Rashtrapati Bhavan on 30 May. President Ramnath Kovind administered the oath of office and secretary at the function. Keys to remember, Narendra Modi took oath as Prime Minister at Rashtrapati Bhavan on 30th May. President Ramnath Kovind administered the oath. Next news. Muhammadu Buhari sworn in for a second term as Nigeria's president. He is a former military ruler, won 56% of the votes to defeat his main challenger, former vice president Akitu Abubakar of the People's Democratic Party in the February election. Keys to remember, Muhammadu Buhari sworn in for a second term as Nigeria's president. He is a former military ruler, won 56% of the votes to defeat his main challengers. Next, let us see important days. Every year on 31st May, the World Health Organization and global partners celebrates No Tobacco Day. The annual campaign is an opportunity to raise awareness on harmful and deadly effects of tobacco use and secondhand smoke exposure and to discourage the use of tobacco in any forms. The focus of World No Tobacco Day 2019 is on tobacco and lung health. Keys to remember, every year 31st May is observed as World No Tobacco Day. It is celebrated by World Health Organization and global partners. The theme of 2019 World No Tobacco Day is Tobacco and Lung Health. Next.
Date 2nd June 2019. Let us start with national news. Rajasthan Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot announced the ban on the sale of e-cigarettes in Rajasthan. Gehlot issued the order on the occasion of World No Tobacco Day on May 31. The government had banned the online or offline sale, storage, production, distribution and advertisements of e-cigarettes in the state. Is to remember, Rajasthan Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot announced the ban on the sale of e-cigarettes in Rajasthan on the occasion of World No Tobacco Day on May 31. Next news, the invasive caterpillar salivating CP, which smoothers and kills coral reefs, has spread its wings to coral reef areas in Malay Islands in the Gulf of Mannar and set to invade new coral colonies in the Marine National Park. Macrofauna and fish density decreased when caterpillar cover increased. Is to remember, in Malay Islands in the Gulf of Mannar, the invasive caterpillar salivating CP, which smoothers and kills coral reefs, spread its wings to coral reef areas. Next, let's see international news. US hospital revealed the birth of a baby girl named Sebi and said she is believed to be the world's smallest surviving baby, who weighed 245 grams at birth. Born at 23 weeks and 3 days in December, she was in neonatal intensive care unit for 5 months. Initially, doctors said she would survive for only an hour. Is to remember, a baby girl named Sebi, who weighed 245 grams at birth, believed to be the world's smallest surviving baby. Next, let's see economic news. FICCIS, Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, Economic Output Survey projected India's median GDP, gross domestic product, 7.1% for FY20 and 7.2% for FY21. The survey was conducted among economists belonging to the industry, banking and financial service sectors of survey for 2019-20. Is to remember, FICCIS Economic Outlook Survey projected India's median GDP 7.1% for FY20 and 7.2% for FY21. Next, let's see appointments. Supreme Court extended the term of Justice B.K. Jain as judicial member of the National Consumer Disputes Redressal Commission. His term was supposed to expire on May 29, 2019. The decision on the extension of term was given by Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi and Justice Aniruddha Bose. Is to remember, Supreme Court extended the term of Justice B.K. Jain as judicial member of the NCERC. The extension of term was given by the Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi and Justice Aniruddha Bose. Next, let's see important dates. World Milk Day is the day established by the Food and Agriculture Organization of United Nations to recognize the importance of milk as a global food. It has been observed on June 1 each year since 2001. The day is intended to provide an opportunity to bring attention to activities that are connected with the dairy sector. Is to remember, World Milk Day is the day established by the Food and Agriculture Organization on June 1 each year since 2001 to recognize the importance of milk as a global food.
Next, date 3rd June 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. Assam government has hiked the parental income limit to waive the admission fees for students taking admissions up to postgraduate level. Students whose parental income is less than 2 lakh rupees per year can avail the benefits. All the professionalized government colleges and 5 universities are incorporated under this scheme. Case to remember, the government of Assam has hiked the parental income limit to waive admission fees for students till postgraduate level. Whose parental income is less than 2 lakh rupees per year can use this benefits. Next news, June 2, 2019 marks the 5th Telangana State Formation Day. On 2nd June 2014, the area was separated from northwestern part of Andhra Pradesh as the newly formed 29th state with Hyderabad as its historical permanent capital. It is also known as India's youngest state. Case to remember, June 2, 2019 marks the 5th Telangana State Formation Day. The area was separated from northwestern part of Andhra Pradesh on 2nd June 2014. Next news, the Union Cabinet has approved the extension of Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi Yojana to all eligible farmer families, irrespective of their size of their land holding. The scheme for farmers was launched by Modi on February 24th. Case to remember, the Union Cabinet has approved the extension of Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi Yojana to all the eligible farmer families, irrespective of the size of their land holding. It is launched by Modi on February 24th. Next, let us see international news updates. The World Health Organization, WHO, will no longer categorize being transgenders as a mental disorder. According to the newly received version of International Classification of Diseases, known as ICD-11, it is published by WHO. Gender identity disorder have been reframed as gender incongruence. The gender incongruence has now been listed under sexual health condition. Case to remember, WHO will no longer categorize being transgender as a mental disorder. Gender incongruence has now been listed under sexual health conditions. Next, let us see economy news updates. India's foreign direct investment equity inflows declined for the first time in 6 years in 2018 to 2019. Data released by Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion and Internal Trade showed FDI India declined 1% to $44.4 billion in the year to 31st March. Case to remember, FDI equity inflows declined for the first time in 6 years in 2018 to 2019. Data released by the Department of Industrial Policies and Promotion and Internal Trade. Next, let us see appointments. In the Central American country of El Salvador, Nayib Bukele has been sworn as the nation's president. Bukele was sworn in by the Speaker of National Assembly in downtown San Salvador. Delegations from 83 countries attended the ceremony. Case to remember, Nayib Bukele has been sworn in as the nation's president of Central American country of El Salvador. 83 countries delegation attended the ceremony. Next, let us see important days. The Global Day of Parents is observed on 1st June every year. The day was proclaimed by UN General Assembly in 2012. The theme of Global Day of Parents is Honor Your Parents. Case to remember, the Global Day of Parents is observed on 1st of June every year. The theme of the Global Day of Parents 2019 is Honor Your Parents. Next, date 4th June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. Ahead of International Yoga Day on 21st June, the Ayush Ministry has launched a mobile application to enable the people to locate yoga events, centers and providing training and instructors. The Yoga Locator, a map-based location app, will also enable yoga instructors to register themselves and reach out to a large number of people. Keys to remember, Yoga Ministry has launched a mobile application on Yoga Day, June 21st. This helps the user to find yoga centers, instructors and events. Next news, in Madhya Pradesh, in a kind of initiative, the tree will now have to be planted for the license of arms. It has been now started from Gwalior, but it can be implemented in other districts as well. After planting a tree, the applicant of license has to be take care of it for a month and then will take a selfie with the plant and submit along with the application form for the license. Keys to remember, Madhya Pradesh have initiated the trees will be planted in license arms. After next plantation, news, the Punjab and Haryana High Court have accorded the status of legal person or entity to animals in Haryana. It has granted them the corresponding rights, duties and inalienabilities of living person. Case to remember, Punjab and Haryana High Court has accorded the status of legal person or entity to animals in Haryana. Next, let us see economy news updates. The Indian economy has lost its spot as the world's fastest growing economy to China. A Reuters survey of economists said that India registered 6.3% annual growth in the January to March quarter, its slowest pace in 6 quarters. China recorded a growth of 6.4% in March quarter. Keys to remember, the Reuters survey of economists said that Indian economy has lost its spot as the world's fastest growing economy to China by registered 6.3% annual growth in the January to March quarter. Next news, oil and natural gas crop. India's top oil and gas producer has top-pledged Indian Oil Corp to retain the crown of being the country's most profitable public sector company. Oil and natural gas crop reported a 34% jump in its 2018 to 2019 fiscal net profit to ₹26,716 crores. Keys to remember, ONGC, India's top oil and gas producer, has top-pledged Indian Oil Corp again, a country's most profitable public sector company. Next, let us see sports news updates. Under 20 Eurasian Athletic Championships held at Almaty, Kazakhstan, Indian juniors have bagged 5 gold and 3 silver medals. Shri Kiran bagged the boys' 800 meter gold with a time of 1 minute 54 seconds and 62 milliseconds, while Rohit Yadav added the 5th gold medal to India's tally, finishing on the top in the boys' javelin throw by clearing a distance of 74.55 meter. Keys to remember, under 20 Eurasian Athletic Championships held at Almaty, Kazakhstan, Indian juniors bagged 5 gold and 3 silver medals. Next, let us see important days. In April 2018, the United Nations General Assembly declared 3rd March as International World Bicycle Day. The day will be observed by all the bicycle enthusiasts across the globe with great excitement and fun. The aim of the event will mainly focus on devoting the particular attention to the bicycle in the current era of automobiles. Keys to remember, April 2018, the United Nations General Assembly declared 3rd June as International World Bicycle Day. The aim of this event is devoting particular attention to the bicycle. Next, date 5th June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will pay 2-day visit to Maldives from 8th June. This will be the first overseas visit of Prime Minister Modi after his re-election. Prime Minister Modi will also visit Sri Lanka on 9th of this month. Keys to remember, on 8th June, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will visit to Maldives and he will visit Sri Lanka on 9th June. This will be his first overseas visit after his re-election. Next news, food grains protection for the agricultural year 2018 to 2019 has been estimated at over 383 million tons. It is the higher by over 17 million tons than the previous 5 years' average production of food grain. As per the third advance estimates, the rice production is estimated at an all-time high of over 115 million tons during 2018 to 2019, beating the previous record of 112 million tons achieved in the 2017 to 2018 crop year. Keys to remember: food grain production for the agricultural year 2018 to 2019 has been estimated at over 383 million tons. It is higher than the previous 5 years' average production. Next news: the Rajasthan government has increased the financial assistance given to the school girls under Aapki Beti scheme. The amount has been increased to 2,100 from 1,100 for the girls studying in class 1 to 8 and for the girls in class 9 to 12, the finance aid has been increased to 2,500 from 1,500. Keys to remember: on Aapki Beti scheme, Rajasthan government increased the financial assistance for school girls. Next, let us see international news updates. UAE's Federal Authority for Identity and Citizenship has issued the first golden residence permit in Abu Dhabi. It has been provided as a part of investigated permanent residence system aimed to attract investors, entrepreneurs and qualified individuals who met its criteria. Keys to remember: UAE's ICA has issued the first golden residence permit in Abu Dhabi, which will provide as a part of investigators' permanent residence system. Next news: the presidential election in Sri Lanka would be held between November 15th and December 7th. The Election Commission Chairman Mahinda Deshpriya has said, clarifying that according to the constitutional provisions, the poll must be held 1 month before the end of current president's term. Keys to remember: the Election Commission Chairman Mahinda Deshpriya has said that presidential election in Sri Lanka would be held between November 15th and December 7th. Next, let us see science and tech updates. NASA's $8.8 billion James Webb Space Telescope, the world's largest and most expensive one, has successfully passed final thermal vacuum test, making its path cleared for the use in space. The 6.5-meter diameter telescope has 18 gold-coated mirror and a tennis court-sized sunsheet to gather light and protect its instruments. The telescope set up to launch in 2021. It took 20 years to build. Keys to remember: the world's largest and most expensive one, NASA's $8.8 billion James Webb Space Telescope, has successfully passed a final thermal vacuum test. This telescope was planned to launch by 2021 and it took 20 years to build it. Next, let us see important days. The International Day of Innocent Children Victims of Aggression is observed on each 4th June. In 1997, the General Assembly adopted the 51/77 resolution on the rights of children. It was estimated on 19th August 1982. Keys to remember: the International Day of Innocent Children Victims of Aggression is observed on 4th June every year. Next, date 6th June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. As a part of its countrywide Go Green initiative, the Indian Army commissioned a continuous ambient air quality monitoring system at Fort William Military Station, Kolkata. The General Officer Commanding in Chief, Eastern Command, commissioned the system, which monitors air pollution on a real-time basis. Keys to remember: Indian Army commissioned a continuous ambient air quality monitoring system as a part of its countrywide Go Green, which monitors air pollution on a real-time basis. Next news. Boeing has signed a technical assistance agreement with Airport Authority of India to jointly develop a comprehensive 10-year roadmap for modernizing air traffic management in India. The roadmap is expected to be developed within 18 months and it will be undertaken with a grant from the United States Trade and Development Agency. Keys to remember: to develop a comprehensive 10-year roadmap for modernizing air traffic, Boeing has signed a technical assistance agreement with Airport Authority of India. Next news, the World Bank retained its forecast of India's growth rate at 7.5% for the current fiscal year. In its Global Economic Prospect report, the World Bank also said growth rate is expected to remain the same for the next two fiscals. According to the report, private consumption and investment will benefit from strengthening credit growth, accommodative monetary policy, with inflation having fallen below the Reserve Bank of India's target. Keys to remember: the World Bank retained its forecast of India's growth rate at 7.5%. This benefits from strengthening credit growth, more accommodative monetary policy with inflation. Next, let us see sports news updates. The Indian junior women's hockey team clinched Cantor Fidjerlin U21 International Four Nation title after beating Ireland 1-0 in the finals at Dublin, Ireland. The win meant India ended the tournament with an unblemished record. With 3 goals in 4 games, Mumtaz Khan finished as the highest goal scorer of the tournament. Keys to remember: Indian junior women's hockey team clinched the title of Cantor Fidjerlin U21 International, the Four Nations, by beating Ireland 1-0. Next, let us see appointments. Comptroller and Auditor General of India, Rajiv Maharishi, has been elected as External Auditor of the World Health Organization for 4 years from 2020 to 2023. Maharishi was elected at the 72nd World Health Assembly in Geneva last month with majority. Keys to remember: the Comptroller and Auditor General of India, Rajiv Maharishi, has been elected as External Auditor of World Health Organization. She will be in the post for 4 years from 2020 to 2023. Next, let us see awards. Google's India-born CEO Sundar Pichai and Nasdaq President Adina Friedman has been chosen for the prestigious Global Leadership Awards 2019. The award is given by Business Advocacy Group USIBC in recognition of the two companies' contribution as the leading technology-driven platform. Keys to remember: Global Leadership Awards 2019 have chosen Google's India-born CEO Sundar Pichai and Nasdaq President Adina Friedman for the prestigious awards. Next, let us see important days. World Entertainment Day is observed every year on 5th of June. The day is celebrated every year to raise global awareness to take positive environmental action to protect nature and the planet. This year, theme of Environment Day is Air Pollution. Keys to remember: World Environment Day is observed every year on 5th of June. This year, theme of World Environment Day is Air Pollution. Next, date 7th June 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman will attend the two-day meeting of G20 finance ministers and central bank governors in Japan on June 8th and 9th. This will be the first overseas visit of Ms. Sitharaman as finance minister. Besides Ms. Sitaraman, RBI Governor Shakti Kanda Das is also likely to attend the meeting at Fukuoka in Japan. Keys to remember, Finance Minister Nirmala Sitaraman will be attending G20 meeting on June 8th and 9th. This will be her first overseas visit as Finance Minister. Next news, in a bid to spur investment and create new opportunities, Prime Minister Narendra Modi set up two cabinet committees to deal with the two critical issues. Both the panels respectively on investment and growth and on employment and skill development will head by Prime Minister. Keys to remember, Prime Minister Narendra Modi set up two cabinet committees to deal with spur investment and create new employment opportunities. Next, let us see international news updates. The second Global Disability Summit being held in Buenos Aires, Argentina. Disability Summit Argentina 2019. The 3-day summit will be held from 6th June to 8th June 2019. India will be represented by Minister of Social Justice and Empowerment Thavar Chand Gahlot. Keys to remember, the second Global Disability Summit being held from 6th June to 8th June in Buenos Aires, Argentina. Next news, in Nahaland, the scenic Zuko Valley has become plastic-free zone on the occasion of World Environment Day. The much appreciated initiative on declaring this scenic valley as plastic-free zone was taken by South Angami Youth Organization. Keys to remember, the scenic Zuko Valley in Nahaland has become plastic-free zone on occasion of World Environment Day. Next, let us see science and tech updates. China launched a space rocket from the sea for the first time on 5th June 2019. With this, China will be the third nation to successfully demonstrate the ability to launch satellites into orbit from a floating platform, following the USA and Russia. In this operation, March 11, a long rocket was launched from a ship in the LOC. Keys to remember, on 5th June 2019, China launched a space rocket from sea for the first time on 5th June 2019. China will be the third nation to successfully demonstrate the ability to launch satellite into orbit from floating platform. Next, let us see appointments. In March, the board of Axis Bank had approved the appointment of Rakesh Mukija as a chairman subject to RBI clearance. Rakesh Mukija, independent director, was appointed as the non-executive chairman of the bank for a period of 3 years with effect from July 18, 2019 up to July 17, 2022. Keys to remember, Rakesh Mukija appointment as a chairman has been approved by the board of Axis Bank. Next, let us see awards. The veteran actress Sheila was chosen for the prestigious J.C. Daniel Award. It is the Kerala government's highest honor for the outstanding contribution to Malayalam cinema. The annual honor is named after J.C. Daniel, who made the first silent movie in Bollywood. Keys to remember, veteran actress Sheila was chosen for the prestigious J.C. Daniel Award, which is honored by Kerala government for the outstanding contribution to Malayalam cinema. Next, date 8th June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. The Culture Minister Prahlad Singh Patel inaugurated the exhibition titled Unknown Masterpieces of Himachal Forghat at National Museum in New Delhi. The exhibition is being jointly organized by the National Museum and Home of Forghat, Gurugram, in which more than 240 artifacts will be on display. Keys to remember, Culture Minister Prahlad Singh Patel inaugurated the exhibition titled Unknown Masterpieces of Himachal Folk Art, which is jointly organized by National Museum and Home of Folk Art. Next news, our External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar will embark on the two-day visit to Bhutan. This is Mr. Jaishankar's first overseas visit after assuming the charge of the ministry. During the visit, Mr. Jaishankar will call on Bhutanese Prime Minister Lotay Shoring and met his counterpart Thandi Dorji. Keys to remember, our External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar will be on two-day visit to Bhutan. This is his first overseas visit after taking the charge of the ministry. Next news, the Reserve Bank of India in its bi-monthly monetary policy review today reduced the repo rate by 25 basis points to 5.75% from 6.0% with immediate effect. Consequently, the reverse repo rate stands adjusted to 5.50% and the marginal standing facility rate and the bank rate to 6.0%. Keys to remember, the RBI bi-monthly monetary policy review today reduced the repo rate by 25 basis points to 5.75% from 6.0% with immediate effect. The reverse repo rate stands adjusted by 5.0% from 6.0%. Next, let us see international news updates. The Indian and French Air Forces will carry out a two-week-long Meha Air exercise beginning July 1st in France. A fleet of Sukhoi 30 fighter jets of Indian Air Force will engage with dog flights with the France Rafale multi-role aircrafts in simulated scenarios as a part of Garuda exercise. Keys to remember, the two-week-long mega air exercise begins on July 1st in France, where India and France Air Forces will be participated. Next, let us see appointments. Kumar Iyer has been appointed by UK government as a chief economist of the Foreign and Commonwealth Office. He is the first Indian origin member of the department's management board. Keys to remember, Kumar Iyer has been the first Indian origin member to get appointed by the UK government as a chief economist of Foreign and Commonwealth Office. Next news, Thailand Parliament has elected 2014 Corp leader Prayut Chan-o-cha as Prime Minister. The military packed party that nominated Prayut won the second highest number of seats in the House of Representatives in the general election in March. Keys to remember, Thailand Parliament has elected 2014 Corp leader Prayut Chan-o-cha as a Prime Minister. He won the second highest number of seats in the House of Representatives in the general election. Next, let us see books. Cricket World Cup, The Indian Challenge, a book on the history of tournament from an Indian perspective by veteran broadcaster and writer Ashish Ray, has been formally unveiled by the chief executive of the England and Wales Cricket Board, Tom Harrison. Keys to remember, the veteran broadcaster and writer Ashish Ray have wrote the book Cricket World Cup, The Indian Challenge. It is a book on history of tournament from an Indian perspective. This book was formally unveiled by Chief Executive of the England and Wales Cricket Board, Tom Harrison. Next.
Day 9 June 2019. Let us begin with national news update. British Prime Minister Theresa has officially stepped down as the leader of the Conservative Party but will remain as Prime Minister until her successor is chosen. She had announced to resign on 24th of the last month. May has stepped down amid mounting pressure over her repeatedly defeated Brexit deal. Keys to remember, British Prime Minister had announced to resign on 24th of last month. May has stepped down amid mounting pressure over her repeatedly defeated Rashid Dee. Next news. To mark the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, Indian Embassy in Saudi organized Gandhi Cycle Rally for Peace in association with the Diplomatic Water Authority and Saudi Cycling Federation. The rally was flagged off by Rasif Azai, Ambassador of India to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Please to remember, Indian Embassy in Saudi organized Gandhi Cycle Rally for Peace in association with Diplomatic Water Authority and Saudi Cycling Federation for to remember 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. This rally was flagged off by Rasif Azai. Next news. The Reserve Bank of India has imposed a monetary penalty of ₹2 crore on Kotak Mahindra Bank for non-compliance of directions. The central bank had in March directed Kotak Mahindra Bank to furnish information about details of the shares held by its promoters and to submit details of the proposed course of action, plans, strategy for complying with promoter timeline to dilution for of promoter shareholding. Please to remember, the Reserve Bank of India has imposed a monetary penalty of ₹2 crore on Kotak Mahindra Bank for non-compliance of direction. Kotak Mahindra Bank submit details of the proposed course of actions, plans, strategy for complying with the promoter timeline for dilution of promoter shareholding. Next, let's see international news. Confederation of Indian Industry has launched a fiscal performance index to assess state and central budgets. The index incorporates qualitative assessments of revenue expenditure, capital expenditure, revenues, fiscal prudence and the level of public debt arrive at a more holistic picture of fiscal performance than the fiscal deficit to GDP ratio according to the key, that means Confederation of Indian Industry. Please to remember, Confederation of Indian Industry has launched a fiscal performance index to assess state and central budgets. Next, let's see appointment news. Former Chief Election Commissioner N. Gopalaswamy has been appointed as an electoral officer for the BCCI annual general meeting. The Committee of Administrators had last month announced that the long-awaited election of the BCCI will be held on 22nd October. Please to remember, N. Gopalaswamy, whom former Chief Election Commissioner has been appointed as an electoral officer for the BCCI. The Committee of Administrators announced that the election of BCCI will be held on 22nd October. Next, let's see sports news. Indian archers secure 2 quota places each in the recurve and compound section for next year's Tokyo Paralympics after dishing out superb performance at the World Para Championships in the Netherlands. Punjabi University's Harvinder Singh and Uttar Pradesh's Vivek Chitra finished jointly to bag the 2 available berths in the recurve men's open section. Keys to remember, Punjabi University Harvinder Singh and Uttar Pradesh Vivek Chitra finished jointly to bag the 2 available berths in the recurve men's open section.
Next, date 10th June 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. The Commerce and Industry Minister Piyush Goyal is leading the Indian delegation for the 2-day G20 ministerial meeting on trade and digital economy beginning at Tsukuba City in Japan. Mr. Goyal will discuss developments in the global trade situation, WTO matters and digital trade. Keys to remember, the Commerce and Industry Minister Piyush Goyal will lead the G20 ministerial meeting at Tsukuba City in Japan. Next news. The government has notified its decisions to extend the benefit of 6,000 rupees per year to eligible farmers under the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi scheme. This decision will benefit all 14.5 crores farmers irrespective of their size of their land holding in the city. Keys to remember, under the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi scheme, the government will extend the benefit of 6,000 rupees per year to eligible farmers. Next, let us see international news updates. The African Union suspended Sudan until the establishment of civilian rule, intensifying global pressure on its new military leaders to stand down after the worst violence since Omar al-Bashir falls in April. Meeting in Ethiopia's capital, Addis Ababa, the AU's Peace and Security Council invoked its response to interruption of constitutional rule by suspending Sudan. Keys to remember, Sudan is suspended by African Union until the establishment of civilian rule in intensifying global pressure on its new military leaders. Next news, Sri Lankan Airlines, the flag carrier of the island nation, has been named the world's most punctual airline. It has been named for the second consecutive time with over 90% of its flights in May being on time. In May, it achieved a punctuality rating of 90.75%. Case to remember, Sri Lankan Airlines has been named the world's most punctual airline with over 90% of its flights in May being on time. Next, let us see appointment. Justice Prashant Kumar was appointed as the Acting Chief Justice of Jharkhand High Court as its incumbent the Duraibhai Narainbhai Patel has been appointed as the Chief Justice of Delhi High Court. Justice Patel took charge in the Delhi HC on June 7th. Keys to remember, Justice Prashant Kumar was appointed as the Acting Chief Justice on the Jharkhand High Court. Next, let us see awards. Prime Minister Narendra Modi was conferred with Maldives' highest civilian award, the Order of Distinguished Rule of Izzuddin, by the President of Host Countries, Ibrahim Mohammed Soli. The award is a recognition of many services Prime Minister Modi has offered to cement the long-standing and amicable ties between the two countries. Keys to remember, Prime Minister Narendra Modi was offered with Maldives' highest civilian award, the Order of Distinguished Rule of Izzuddin. The award was presented by President of Host Countries, Ibrahim Mohammed Soli. Next, let us see important days. The World Ocean Day is celebrated on 8th June every year to empower the people of all ages to become leaders of their own and stop polluting oceans and water bodies. Keys to remember, every year 8th June is observed as World Ocean Day. It is observed to create an awareness about polluting ocean and other water bodies. Next, date 11th June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. The country's foreign exchange reserves increased by $1.875 billion to $421.867 billion in the week ending May 31st. The Reserve Bank weekly data released showed that foreign currency assets, which is a major component of overall reserves, rose by $1.946 billion to $394.134 billion. Keys to remember, the country's foreign exchange reserves increased by $1.875 billion to $421.867 billion, released by RBI data. Next news, imports from Pakistan to India has declined by 92% to $2.84 million US dollars in March this year. Behind This decline is the imposition of 200% custom duties on all products following Pulwama terror attack. Keys to remember, import from Pakistan to India has declined by 92% to $2.84 million in March this year. The reason behind this decline is following Pulwama terror attack. Next news, Delhi Metro becomes the first ever project in the country to receive power granted from waste to energy plant. The Delhi Metro Rail Corporation receiving 2 MW power from 12 MW capacity waste to energy plant setup in Ghazipur. Keys to remember, Delhi Metro becomes the first ever project in the country to receive power generated from a waste to energy plant, which is receiving 2 MW power from a 12 MW capacity waste to energy plant. Next, let us see international news updates. The UAE cabinet adopted the National Strategy for Well-being 2031 during its meeting at Presidential Palace in Abu Dhabi. One of the most important initiatives is the development of the first National Well-being Observatory as support to policy-making process. Keys to remember, the UAE cabinet adopted the National Strategy for Well-being 2031 in the meeting held at Abu Dhabi. Next, let us see science and tech updates. The supersonic cruise missile BrahMos was test fired from integrated test range at Chandipur in Odisha. Anti-ship version of the missile launched by Complex 3 of ITR, Defense Research and Development Source. Keys to remember, supersonic cruise missile BrahMos was test fired at Chandipur in Odisha by Defense Research and Defense Development Resource. Next, let us see economy news updates. The Indian Air Force signed a deal with Israel to buy more than 100 these 2000 bombs worth around Rs 300 crores. Space bombs were used by Indian Air Force to attack Madrasa of Jaish-e-Mohammed in Balakot, Pakistan on February 26 in response to the terror attack on CRPF convoy in Pulwama, which resulted in martyrdom of 40 CRPF personnel. Keys to remember, the Indian Air Force signed a deal with Israel to buy more than 100 Spies 2000 bombs worth around Rs 300 crores. Next, let us see appointments. P. Jayadevan appointed as a Executive Director of Indian Oil Corporation Limited for Tamil Nadu and Puducherry with immediate effect. He succeeds R. Sitradhan. He will function as a coordinator of an oil industry in the state and also in the Union Territory. He will head as a Chairman's Secretariat at Corporate Office, New Delhi. Keys to remember, P. Jayadevan appointed as Executive Director of Indian Oil Corporation Limited for Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. He will head as a Chairman's Secretariat at Corporate Office, New Delhi. Next. Date 12th June 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has accepted an invitation from French President Emmanuel Macron to attend the outreach session of G7 summit in Beatrice as special invitee. The 45th summit of G7 group of countries will take place from August 24th to August 26th in Beatrice, France. Keys to remember, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has accepted an invitation from French President Emmanuel Macron for the 45th summit of G7 group. The group of countries will take place from August 24th to August 26th in Beatrice, France. Next news, Bharat Stage 4 norms for two-wheelers have been released. In order to curb air pollution, through the vehicular emissions, the government has decided to implement BS4 norms with effect from 1st April 2020. Keys to remember: Bharat Stage 4 norms for two-wheelers have been released in order to curb air pollution by vehicular emissions. Next news: Crazy Mogan, a renowned dialogue writer in Tamil film industry, passed away. The veteran playwriter passed away due to cardiac arrest at the private hospital. His real name is Mohan Rangachari and he was fondly known as Crazy Mohan because of his hit skit called Crazy Thieves in Palavakkam. Keys to remember: a renowned dialogue writer in Tamil film industry, Crazy Mogan, was passed away. His real name is Mohan Rangachari. Next news: India has partnered with Portugal to set up a National Maritime Heritage Museum at Lotahal in Gujarat. Indian Navy will be the stakeholders in the project and Portuguese Navy will assist as they have experience in it by administrating the Maritime Museum in Lisbon, Portugal. Keys to remember: India has partnered with Portugal to set up a National Maritime Heritage Museum at Lotahal in Gujarat. The Portuguese Navy will assist them since they have experience in administrating the Maritime Museum. Next, let us see international news updates. Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau announced that single-use plastics will be banned in the country from 2021. He declared it is a global challenge to phase out the plastic bags, straws and cutlery clogging in the world's ocean. Keys to remember: Canadian Prime Minister have announced that ban on single-use plastics from 2021. Next, let us see sports news updates. Yuvraj Singh announced retirement from international cricket, ending a roller coaster career. He put together 1,900 runs in the longest format and 8,701 in the one days, and the format in which he enjoyed the most success. Yuvraj played 40 tests, 304 ODIs and 58 T20Is for India. Keys to remember: Yuvraj Singh announced a retirement from international cricket. Yuvraj played 40 tests, 304 ODIs and 58 T20Is for India. Next, let us see important days. The International Labour Organization launched World Day Against Child Labour in 2002 to focus attention on the global extent of child labour and the action and efforts needed to eliminate it. The 2019 theme: Child should not work in fields but on their dreams. Keys to remember: World Anti-Child Labour Day is observed on 12th June every year. Theme of the day is Child should not be working in field but on their dreams. Next, date 13th June 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. Cyclone Vayu over East Central Arabian Sea has intensified into a very severe cyclonic storm. It currently lays centered about 420 kilometers west-northwest of Goa, 320 kilometers south-southwest of Mumbai and 420 kilometers south of Veerabal in Gujarat. Keys to remember: very severe cyclonic storm Cyclone Vayu has intensified over East Central Arabian Sea. Next news: Prime Minister Narendra Modi is on a two-day visit to Kyrgyzstan for SCO summit at Bishkek. The visit is expected to further boost the bilateral ties with Kyrgyzstan. The focus will remain on the sectors like pharmaceuticals, textiles, manufacturing and machinery, among others. Keys to remember: Prime Minister Narendra Modi is on two-day visit to Kyrgyzstan for SCO summit. The focus will remain on the sectors like pharmaceuticals, textiles, manufacturing and machinery. Next, let us see economy news updates. Amazon launched the world's most valuable brand in cloud computing, customer tech and movie production. It is founded by the world's richest man, Jeff Bezos. According to the 2019 Brand's Top 100 Most Valuable Global Brand Rankings, Amazon Online Retailer, its brand value quintuple in past 5 years to reach $315.5 million. Keys to remember, Amazon launched the world's most valuable brand in cloud computing, customer tech and movie production. The Amazon Online Retailer set its brand value quintuple in past 5 years. Next, let us see appointments. Union Minister of Social Justice and Empowerment Talwar Chand Gahlot has been appointed as the leader of Rajya Sabha. He will replace senior BJP leader Arun Jaitley, who opted out of the government citing health reasons. Gahlot is a Rajya Sabha member representing Madhya Pradesh. Keys to remember, Union Minister of Social Justice and Empowerment Talwar Chand Gahlot has been appointed as the leader of Rajya Sabha. He will be representing Madhya Pradesh. Next, let us see awards. The Jnanpeeth Award for the year 2018 will be given to the noted English writer Amitabh Ghosh. Former Governor Gopalakrishna Gandhi will present the award to him at the function in New Delhi. The award is given for the outstanding contribution in literature. Keys to remember, the Jnanpeeth Award for the 2018 is conferred to the English writer Amitabh Ghosh for his outstanding contribution in literature. Next, let us see important days. The International Albinism Awareness Day is observed on 13th June worldwide. The theme of Albinism Awareness Day is Still Standing Strong. Keys to remember, the International Albinism Awareness Day is observed on June 13th with the theme Still Standing Strong. Next, date 14th June 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. In Uttar Pradesh, the state government has hiked the old age pension in the age group 60 to 79 years by rupees 100 monthly. Now the old age pensioners would receive 500 rupees per month from the existing 400 rupees. Keys to remember, Uttar Pradesh government has hiked the old age pension for the age group 60 to 79 years from rupees 400 to 500 monthly. Next news. Melakir Bhavani festival was celebrated in Jammu and Kashmir on Zasht Ashtami. Hundreds of Kashmiri Pandit devotees prayed at the famous Ragna Devi temple here in Jammu and Kashmir's Gandharbal district. Keys to remember, Melakir Bhavani festival was celebrated in Jammu and Kashmir on Zasht Ashtami. Hundreds of Kashmiri Pandit devotees prayed at the famous Rangya Devi temple at Gandharbal district. Next news. Bihar cabinet led by Chief Minister Nitish Kumar has approved the proposal to punish sons and daughters who abandon their elderly parents with a jail term. The proposal of Bihar Social Welfare Department has provisioned for the punishments which should go up to imprisonment if wards do not look after their parents properly in their old ages. Keys to remember, Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar has approved the proposal to punish the sons and daughters who abandon their parents in their elderly age with the jail term. Next, let us see international news updates. The 16th Asia Media Summit kicked off in Cambodia. The conference is deliberating on many issues pertaining to the media and broadcasting industry. The ministry from different countries presented their digital trends in the broadcasting sector in their respective countries. Keys to remember, the 16th Asian Media Summit kicked off in Cambodia. Deliberating many issues pertaining to the media and broadcasting industry. Next news, Japan will invest rupees 13,000 crores in the several outgoing as well as new infrastructure project in the northeast region. Some of the important project in which Japan will collaborate include the Guwahati water supply project, Guwahati sewage project, the northeast road network connectivity improvement project spread over Assam and Meghalaya, and northeast network connectivity improvement project in Meghalaya. Keys to remember, Japan will invest 13,000 crores on northeast region on ongoing and new infrastructures. Japan will collaborate with Guwahati water supply project and sewage project, the northeast road network connectivity improvement project over Assam and Meghalaya. Next, let us see economy news updates. The Max Life Insurance Company, one of the famous insurance companies in India, announced the launch of unique proprietary tool, My Protection Quotient, its commitment to ensuring the financial protection in the country. Keys to remember, a unique proprietary tool, My Protection Quotient, is announced to launch by Max Life Insurance Company to ensure the financial protection in the country. Next. Date 15th June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. According to Mary Meeker's Internet Trends 2019 report, India accounts for 12% of world's internet users. Almost 3.8 billion people, or more than half of the world's population, is on the internet. China continues to be on the top of the list, counting for 21% of the total internet users. Keys to remember, India accounts for 12% of world's internet users, almost 3.8 billion people, according to 2019 report of Mary Meeker's Internet Trends, where China remains on the top. Next news, the government has reduced the rate of contribution made by employee and employers under the Employer State Insurance Act from 6.5% to 4%. The government has taken the historic decision to reduce the rate of contribution under the ESI Act. The new rate will be effective from 1st of July. Keys to remember, the government has reduced the rate of contribution made by employees and employers under the Employee State Insurance Act from 6.5% to 4%, which will be active from 1st of July. Next, let us see science and tech updates. India is to launch Aditya L1, its first mission to study the Sun, in 2020. Indian Space Research Organization Chairman K. Shivan informed. The aim of this mission is to keep a permanent eye on the Sun without any disturbance. Aditya L1 is meant to observe the solar corona. Keys to remember, India is to launch Aditya L1, its first mission to study the Sun, in 2020, informed by K. Shivan. Next, let us see economy news updates. Foreign direct investment to India grew by 6% to $42 million in 2018. It grew with a strong inflow in the manufacturing, communication, financial services sector and cross-border merger and acquisition activities. The report ranked India among the top 20 host economies for the FDI inflow in 2017 to 2018. Keys to remember, the foreign direct investment to India grew by 6% to $42 million in 2018. The top 20 host economies for the FDI inflow in 2017 to 2018. Next, let us see appointments. Kazim Jomart Yokayev took oath as the new president of Kazakhstan. He was acting president following the surprise resignation of Nursultan Nazarbayev in March this year. The career diplomat became the country's second elected president after succeeding 78 years old Nursultan Nazarbayev. Keys to remember, Kazim Jomart Tokayev took oath as the new president of Kazakhstan. He is country's second elected president after succeeding 78 years old Nur Sultan Nazarbayev. Next, let us see awards. Actress Priyanka Chopra will be awarded the Danny Kaye Humanitarian Award by UNICEF's American chapter at their Snowflake Ball in December. The award is named after the actor philanthropist Danny Kaye, who was UNICEF's first Goodwill Ambassador. The actor is a UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador, as a part of which she visited Ethiopia last month. Keys to remember, actress Priyanka Chopra will be awarded the Danny Kaye Humanitarian Award by UNICEF's American chapter in this December. Next, let us see important days. Every year on 14th June, countries around the world celebrate World Blood Donor Day. The event, established in 2004, serves to raise the awareness of the need for the safe blood and blood products and to thank the blood donors for their voluntary life-saving gift of blood. Theme of this year is Save Blood for All. Keys to remember, every year 14th June is observed as World Blood Donor Day. The theme of 2019 is Save Blood for All. Next.
Day 16th June 2019. Let us beginning with national news update. India has slipped by 4 points in an annual global index on peacefulness this year, finishing at 141 among 163 countries. Iceland remained at the top of position, according to a report by an international think tank. The Global Peace Index, GPI, gauges ongoing domestic and international conflict, safety and security in society, and the decree of militarization in 163 countries and territories by taking into account 23 indicators. Keys to remember, India has slipped by 4 points into an annual global index on peacefulness this year, finishing at 141 among 163 countries. Iceland remained at the top position, according to a report by an international think tank. Next, Rajat Singh Patel, Minister of State of Culture and Tourism, Government of India, inaugurated the exhibition titled Aztec Walk, the Essence of Prabhakar Bhavye, at National Gallery of Modern Art, New Delhi. Highlighting the significance of museums, the culture minister said that museums are required to look into our past thereby helping us to move forward in life by learning things from the past. The minister also added the Museum Act as a symbol of respect for her ancestors. Keys to remember, Prahlad Singh Patel, Minister of State of Culture and Tourism, Government of India, inaugurated the exhibition titled Aztec Walk, the Essence of Prabhakar Bhavye, at National Gallery of Modern Art, New Delhi. The minister also added the museum's actors as symbol of respect for our ancestors.
Next, PM Narendra Modi and Uzbekistan President Jeenbekov inaugurated Indian BRICS Business Forum. The two leaders also asked their business communities to explore the untapped potential for deepening bilateral relationship between two countries. Keys to remember, PM Narendra Modi and Uzbekistan President Jeenbekov inaugurated Indian BRICS Business Forum.
Next, let's see economic news. The Government of India has taken a historic decision to reduce the rate of contribution under the ESA Act from 6.5% to 4%. Employees' contribution being reduced from 4.75% to 3.25%, and employees' contribution being reduced from 1.75% to 0.75%. Reduced rates will be effective from 1st July 2019. This would benefit of 3.6 crore employees and 12.85 lakh employees. Keys to remember,
the Government of India has taken a historic decision to reduce the rate of contribution under the ESA Act from 6.5% to 4%. This would benefit 3.64 employees and 12.85 lakh employees. Next, let's see sports news. India remains unmoved at 101 position after FIFA. The apex body of football released the latest team ranking. Belgium strengthens their top position, adding 9 points to the previous standings. India was not able to improve their rank as they remained at the same spot, and their points too were unchanged from the previous standings of 12-19 points. Please do remember, India remains unmoved at 101 position after FIFA. The apex of body of football released the latest team rankings. India was not able to improve their ranks as they remained at the same spot, and their points too were unchanged from the previous standings of 12-19 points. Next, let's see awards. Composer Bhushan Kumar has been felicitated with an official certificate from Guinness World Records as T-Series became the first YouTube channel to reach 100 million subscribers. Keys to remember, composer Bhushan Kumar has been felicitated with an official certificate from Guinness World Record as T-Series became the first YouTube channel to reach 100 million subscribers. Next, let's see important dates. World Elder Abuse Awareness Day is held on June 15th every year. The UN aims to raise awareness of elder abuse and prevent it, and on this day, elder abuse is global and comes in many forms, including physical, emotional, sexual and financial abuse, and also neglect. Please do remember, World Elder Abuse Awareness Day is held on June 15th every year.
Next, date 17th June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. Central government has permitted to set up e-foreigner tribunal in Assam. It is a quasi-judicial authority which assesses the question of the authenticity of the person's citizenship. It should be set up by July 31, 2019, when the final list of National Register of Citizens, NRC, is published. Keys to remember, central government has permitted to set up e-foreigners tribunal in Assam, and it should be set up by July 31, 2019. Next news, Bharat Dynamics Limited has signed a contract worth of Rs. 1187.82 crores for the supply of heavyweight torpedoes and Varunastra to Indian Navy. The execution of contract will be over the next 42 months. The weapons will be manufactured at VDL Vishakhapatnam unit under the collaboration with Defence Research and Development Organisation. Keys to remember, the supply of heavyweight torpedoes Varunastra, the Indian Navy, the BDL has signed a contract worth of 1187.82 crores, which will be executed in over next 42 months. Next, let us see science and tech updates. A team of Tribhuvan University and National Geographic Society scientists and researchers have installed the world's highest fully automated weather station on the top of Mount Everest. The total 5 weather stations, including one at record height of 27,657 feet, were installed on Earth's highest mountain above the sea level. Keys to remember, the world's highest fully automated weather stations was installed on the Earth's highest mountain, Mount Everest, by a team Tribhuvan University and National Geographic Society scientists and researchers. It is 27,657 feet higher than the sea level. Next, let us see economy news updates. The Asian Development Bank has approved the projects for the infrastructure development worth Rs. 1,650 crores in 7 of 8 district headquartered towns in Tripura. The Urban Development Department of Tripura government had submitted the project's details to the ADB through the central government, on which the ADB gave its nod. Keys to remember: ADB has approved the project for infrastructure development worth of Rs. 1,650 crores. It is implemented in 7 of 8 district headquarters in Tripura. Next, let us see sports news update. Jyoti Surekha Venam produced a stellar show to help India clutch 2 bronze medals in the compound women's section of Archery World's Championship in the Netherlands. The Asian Games silver medalist first led the fight back in the team event by shooting 6 perfect 10s out of 8 arrows. Keys to remember: Jyoti Surekha, India clutched a 2 bronze medal in the compound women's section of Archery World Championship held in Netherlands. Next, let us see appointments. Anti-corruption campaigner Susana Kapitova has been sworn in as Slovakia's first female president. This swearing-in took place before the Constitutional Court Chair Ivan Fiakan during a ceremonial parliamentary session held in Bratislava. Keys to remember: the anti-corruption campaigner Susana has been sworn in as Slovakia's first female president. This swearing took place before the Constitutional Court Chair Ivan Fiakan. Next, let us see awards. Suman Rao from Rajasthan has won the Femina Miss India World 2019 beauty pageant during a star-studded ceremony at Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel Indoor Stadium. Keys to remember: Suman Rao from Rajasthan has won the Femina Miss India World 2019 beauty pageant. Next, let us see important days. Father's Day is celebrated every year on the third Sunday of June to honor the journey of fatherhood and the role that fathers play in the family structure and society. This year, it will be celebrated on June 16th, Sunday in India. It complements a similar celebration honoring the family members such as Mother's Day, Sibling Day and Grandparents Day. Keys to remember: to honor the fatherhood, the Father's Day is celebrated every year on 3rd Sunday of June. This year, it is celebrated June 16th in India. Next.
Date 18-6-2019. Let us start with national news updates. Punjab Minister Sukhbinder Singh Sarkaria met a team of experts from Israel in Chandigarh to prepare a comprehensive water management master plan for the state. The expert will submit their report of recommendations within 18 months. Earlier, the Israeli team visited various parts of the state to assert the present situation and the challenges in the water sector in the state. Keys to remember: Punjab Minister Sukhbinder Singh Sarkaria met a team of experts from Israel in Chandigarh to prepare a comprehensive water management master plan for the state. The expert will submit their report of recommendations within 18 months.
Next news. Assam Transport Minister Chandra Mohan Patowari launched the State Transport Corporation's Chalo App for Guwahati. The app will help commutes to know about the live arrival time of their bus, so they can plan their travel accordingly. People can also track the live GPS position of their bus on a map. It will also ensure safe travel with features such as emergency SOS. Keys to remember. Assam Transport Minister Chandra Mohan Patowari launched the State Transport Corporation's Chalo app for Guvagatti. People can also track the live GPS position of their bus on a map. It will also ensure safe travel with features such as emergency SOS. Next, let's see the international updates. After nearly 16 years of exploring the cosmos in infrared light, NASA's Spitzer Space Telescope will be switched off permanently on January 30, 2020. Spitzer is a small but transformational observatory. It captures infrared light, which is often emitted by warm objects that are not quite hot enough to radiate visible light. Keys to remember. After nearly 16 years of exploring the cosmos in infrared light, NASA's Spitzer Space Telescope will be switched off permanently on January 30, 2020. Next, let's see sports news. Indian keeper Virat Kohli became the fastest batsman to reach the 11,000 run mark in the ODI cricket. He achieved the feat in the match between India and Pakistan in the ICC Men's Cricket World Cup. The Indian keeper has just taken 230 ODIs to complete 11,000 runs. Kohli needed 57 runs before this match to reach 11,000 run mark in ODI cricket. Keys to remember, Kohli needed 57 runs before this match to reach 11,000 run mark in ODI cricket. Next, let's see economy. Commerce Ministry of India made a study that trade war between the US and China offers an opportunity to India for boosting export of as many 350 products such as chemicals and granite to these countries. The going on trade war between the US and China an opportunity to India for boosting exports around 350 products such as chemicals and granite to these countries. Keys to remember. The ongoing trade war between the US and China an opportunity to India for boosting exports around 350 products such as chemicals and granite to these countries.
Next.
19th June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. Man Ki Baat, Indian radio program hosted by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, in which he addresses the people of the nation on All India Radio, DD National and DD News. Man Ki Baat is tourizing on June 30th. The program aims to deliver the Prime Minister's voice to the general masses of India. It also aims to spread joy, positivity and celebrate the strength of 130 crore Indians. Keys to remember. The Prime Minister Narendra Modi, in which he addresses the people of the nation on All India Radio, DD National and DD News. It also aims to spread joy, positivity and celebrate the strength of 130 crore Indians. Next news. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has announced that the centre is to set up a high-level task force for agri reforms. The decision was made in the 5th meeting of the NITI Ayog Governing Council. The task force is for undertaking structural reforms in agriculture, including strengthening logistic, produce marketing, food processing, as well as changes to the Essential Commodities Act. Keys to remember, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has announced that the centre is to set up a high-level task force for agri reforms. The task force is for undertaking structural reforms in agriculture, including strengthening logistic, produce marketing, food processing. Next news. The interstitial meeting of Simberley process will be hosted by India from 17th to 21st June 2019 in Mumbai. Besides this, two special forums regarding diamond terminology and artisanal mining, small steps to larger overcomes, will be held during the intersessional. Keys to remember. Two special forums regarding diamond terminology and artisanal mining, small steps to larger overcomes, will be held during the intersessional. Next, let us see appointments. President Ramnath Kovind swore in the 7th term Member of Parliament. Virendra Kumar as a pro tem Speaker of Lok Sabha. As soon as a new Speaker of the 17th Lok Sabha is elected, his role will cease to exist. As pro tem Speaker, Virendra Kumar will preside over the first sitting of the Lok Sabha and administer the oath to the newly elected MPs. Keys to remember. President Ramnath Kovind swore in the 7th term Member of Parliament, Virendra Kumar as a pro tem Speaker of Lok Sabha. Next, let's see awards. 29 journalists from print and electronic media were felicitated with Matri Media Awards for their contribution towards journalism. Apart from media personalities, a social activist has also presented the Bharat Mata Shi at the 44th Matri Sri Media Awards ceremony. The Matri Sri Media Awards was constituted during the emergency. Keys to remember. 29 journalists from print and electronic media were felicitated to Matri Sri Media Awards for their contribution towards journalism. Next, let's see important days. Artistic Pride Day is observed every year on 18th June. Artistic Pride recognizes the importance of pride for artisan and understands it not as a desert but as a difference. Artisan or artisan spectrum disability is a range of complex neurodevelopment disorders characterized by social impairments, communication difficulties, restrictive and repetitive pattern of behavior. Keys to remember. Artistic Pride Day is observed every year on 18th June. Artistic Pride recognizes the importance of pride for artists.
Next. Date 20 June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. Unemployed youth having graduation or equivalent degree will be given unemployment allowance by Rajasthan government. Male applicant will get rupees 3000 per month, while the women and differently abled will get rupees 3500 per month under Chief Minister Yuva Sambal Yojana from February this year. Keys to remember. Rajasthan government have announced the unemployment allowance will be given to unemployed youth having graduation or equivalent degree. Male will get 3000 per month and the female and disabled will get 3500 per month. Next news. The armies of India and Myanmar carried out a 3-week long coordinated operation from May 16th. In this respective border areas named Operation Sunrise 2. They targeted the militant groups operating in Manipur, Nagaland and Assam to burst terror camps. Keys to remember, India and Myanmar armies carried out a 3 weeks long coordinated operation from May 16th in their respective border areas named Operation Sunrise 2. Next, let us see international news updates. The 5th Conference on Interaction and Confidence Building Measures in Asia Summit 2019 was held in Dushanbe, Tajikistan from 14th to 15th June 2019. The theme of 5th Summit is Shared Vision for Secure and More Prosperous CICA Region India is a member of CICA since 1999. Keen to remember, the 5th conference on CICA Summit 2019 was held in Dushanbe, Tajikistan from 14th to 15th June 2019. The theme of the summit is Shared Vision for a Secure and More Prosperous CICA Region. Next, let us see science and tech updates. The lander and rover meant for India's second lunar mission, Chandrayaan-2, reached the ISRO's launch pad at Sriharikota. The rover called Pragyan is installed within the lander known as Vikram. Chandrayaan-2 will be launched aboard India's most powerful booster GSLV Mark III tentatively early in the morning on July 15th with the aim of making the lander to soft land on the south pole of the moon by September 6th. Keen to remember, the lander and rover for India's second lunar mission Chandrayaan-2 reached the ISRO's launch pad at Sriharikota. The rover called Pragyan and the lander known as Vikram. Next, let us see sports news updates. Afghanistan leg spinner Rashid Khan recorded the worst bowling figures in a ICC World Cup match after conceding 110 runs in 9 overs against England. Previous record of conceding 105 runs in 12 overs was held by New Zealand's Martin Sneeden. Keys to remember, Rashid Khan, Afghanistan leg spinner, recorded the worst bowling figures in a ICC World Cup match. Next, let us see appointments. Om Birla, a two-time Bharatiya Janata Party Member of Parliament from Rajasthan, is said to be unanimously elected as the 17th Lok Sabha Speaker. Om Birla was elected to the 17th Lok Sabha from the Kota Bandi constituency. Keys to remember, Om Birla, a two-time Bharatiya Janata Party MP from Rajasthan, is elected as the 17th Lok Sabha Speaker. Next, let us see important dates. World Refugee Day is observed on 20 June every year to raise an awareness about the condition and problems that refugee faces in their lives. The theme for World Refugee Day 2019 is hashtag Step with Refugees. Take a step on World Refugee Day. Keys to remember, World Refugee Day is observed on 20 June every year. The theme of 2019 World Refugee Day is hashtag Step with Refugees. Take a step on World Refugee Day. Next, date 21st June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. The Himachal Pradesh government makes mandatory for truckers to carry a GPS device so that they can be provided all the possible help in case of any emergency. Kullu and Dalhousie have been identified for installation of early warning system. Rampur and Mandi towns have been zeroed in for setting up the relief and rescue base of National Disaster Response Force. Keys to remember, Himachal Pradesh government makes mandatory for truckers to carry a GPS device to help them in case of any emergency. Next news, the National Payment Corporation of India has entered into an agreement with the government of Telangana to offer Mi Seva portal users that options to pay using UPI collect request, RuPay debit and credit cards for service on the portal. The Mi Seva portal of state government offers over 150 government services and surpassed 100 million transactions last year. Keys to remember, NPCI has entered into an agreement with the government of Telangana to offer Mi Seva portal to the users to pay in the different options. State government offers 150 services along with Mi Seva portal. Next news, Indian Navy's first naval as Squadron 550 celebrated its Diamond Jubilee at Naval Base Kochi after completing 60 glorious years of yeoman service to the nation. The squadron has flown 14 different types of aircrafts, starting with the sea land aircraft to the Doiner Maritime Reconnaissance Aircraft being presently flown. Keys to remember: Indian Navy's first naval air squadron 550 celebrated its Diamond Jubilee at Naval Base Kochi, where squadron has flown 14 different types of aircrafts. Next news: IIT Bombay has been ranked India's best university for the second year in a row, gaining a global ranking of 152 in the QS World University Ranking for 2020. Two other Indian universities, IIT Delhi, have scored 182nd rank and the Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru, have scored 184th rank. Keys to remember: IIT Bombay has been ranked India's best university for the second year in a row, where it scores 152nd rank in the QS World University Ranking for 2020. The other Indian institutions in the list are IIT Delhi and Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru. Next, let us see international news updates. India has extended $15 million assistance to Niger for organizing the Asian Union Summit scheduled to be held in Niamey early next month. The summit is scheduled to be held in Niamey from July 7th to 8th. It will also be the first time that Nigeria is scheduled to host an AU summit. Keys to remember: India has extended $50 million assistance to Niger for organizing the Asian Union summit scheduled to be held in Niamey. Next news: WHO offers a new tool aware to contain raising antimicrobial resistance and make antibiotic use safer and more effective. AWARE classifies antibiotics into three groups. Axis specifies which antibiotics to be used for the most common and serious infections. WATCH specifies which one should be available at all time in the healthcare system. RESERVE are those that must be used sparingly or preserved and used only as last resort. Keys to remember: WHO offers a new tool AWARE for raising antimicrobial resistance and make antibiotic usage safer and more effective. The AWARE tool classifies the antibiotics into three groups. They are Axis, WATCH and RESERVE. Next, let us see economy news updates. DBS Bank has revised India's GDP growth for fiscal year 2020 downwards to 6.8% year-on-year from 7% projected earlier, citing headwinds for exports amidst challenging trade outlooks. Keys to remember: DBS Bank has revised India's GDP growth for fiscal year 2020 downwards to 6.8% year-on-year from 7%. Next, date 22nd June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. According to the President of India, construction or upgradation about 35,000 kilometers of national highway ought to be undertaken by Bharat Mala project by 2022. Also under Sagar Mala project, a network of good quality roads ought to be constructed in the coastal areas and areas adjoining ports. Keys to remember: according to the President of India, Bharat Mala project undertaken the construction and upgradation of about 35,000 kilometers of national highway by 2022. Next news: Indian Navy has deployed ships INS Chennai and INS Sunaina in the Gulf of Oman. It has deployed the reassured Indian flagged vessel operating or transmitting through the Persian Gulf and Gulf of Oman following the maritime security incidents in the region. In addition, aerial surveillance by Indian Navy aircraft is also being undertaken in the area. Keys to remember, Indian Navy has deployed ships INS Chennai and INS Sunaina in the Gulf of Oman. It has deployed the reassured Indian flag vessel operating and transmitting through Persian Gulf and Gulf of Oman. Next news, President Ramnath Kovind has highlighted the importance of government's flagship Kilo India program. Addressing the joint sitting of the two houses of parliament, the president said the new government has decided to widen the spectrum of Kilo India program to cover the entire country. Keys to remember, Kilo India program, the importance of government's flagship has been highlighted by President Ramnath Kovind. Next, let us see international news updates. Sri Lanka's first satellite, Ravana 1, designed and developed by the two local engineers, was successfully launched into the orbit this week from the International Space Station, along with two other birds, three satellites from Japan and Nepal. Keys to remember, Sri Lanka's first satellite, Ravana 1, was successfully launched into the orbit this week from International Space Station, along with the two other birds, three satellites from Japan and Nepal. Next, let us see economy news updates. India Bulls Housing Finance said that Competition Commission of India has approved its proposal merger with Lakshmi Vilas Bank. The merged entity, to be called India Bulls Lakshmi Vilas Bank, will be among the top 8 private banks in India by size and profitability. Keys to remember, India Bulls Housing Finance said that CCI approved its proposed merger with Lakshmi Vilas Bank. Next, let us see appointments. India's only individual Olympic gold medalist, Abhinav Bindra, was appointed in an independent capacity by the World Archery to sort out the ongoing mess in the National Federation. The development comes a day after the world body delisted the Archery Association of India for violating the constitution by unanimously electing two parallel bodies in Chandigarh and New Delhi. Keys to remember, Abhinav Bindra, India's only individual Olympic gold medalist, was appointed in an independent capacity by the World Archery in National Federation. Next, let us see important days. International Day of Yoga is celebrated annually on 21st June since its inception in 2015. The idea of International Day of Yoga was first proposed by current Prime Minister of India, Mr. Narendra Modi. International Day of Yoga aims to raise awareness worldwide of the many benefits of practicing yoga. 2019 theme, Yoga for Climate Action. Keys to remember, International Day of Yoga is celebrated annually on 21st June since its inception in 2015. Theme of International Day of Yoga 2019 is Yoga for Climate Action. Next.
Date. 23rd June 2019. Let us begin with national news update. According to officials in the Finance Ministry, GST Council meeting where rate reduction for electric vehicles and the extension of the term of National Anti-Profiteering Authority till November 2020. Tax experts see Council's real focus on addressing concerns regarding the new retail filling system. The startup community is asking for the Council to further streamline the input tax credit refund system. Keys to remember,
According to officials in the Finance Ministry, GST Council meeting where rate reduction for electric vehicles and the extension of the term of the National Anti-Profiting Authority till November 2020.
Next news. The Muslim Women Bill 2019, that's the production of rights on marriage to ban the practice of instant triple talaq, was introduced in the Lok Sabha. The bill was tabled by Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad. The Muslim Women Bill 2019 will replace an ordinance issued in February by the previous NDA government. Things to remember. The Muslim Women Bill 2019 to ban the practice of instant triple talaq was introduced in the Lok Sabha. The bill was tabled by Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad.
Next news. The GST Council has simplified rules for registration and Aadhaar will now be used by business for registration under GST. In the earlier system, people had to give various documents and now several advantages will occur to the business by using Aadhaar. Keys to remember. The GST Council has simplified rules for registration and Aadhaar will now be used by business for registration under GST. Next, let's see international news. The Emirates Airline has taken precautionary measures including rerouting all flights away from areas of possible conflict in the Gulf region. The announcement came a day after an unnamed US drone was repeatedly shot down by Iran in the region. The US Federal Aviation Administration, that's the FAA, had issued an emergency order on prohibiting US air carriers from flying in Iran-controlled airspace over the Strait of Hormuz and Gulf of Oman due to heightened tension. Keys to remember. The Emirates Airline has taken precautionary measures including rerouting all flights away from areas of possible conflict in the Gulf region. The announcement came a day after an unnamed US drone was repeatedly shot down by Iran in the region. Next news. The first international theater festival of Bangladesh is being held at Bangladesh Shilpakala Academy in Dhaka. The week-long festival will feature theater and puppet shows by 8 troupes from 7 countries. Things to remember. The first international theater festival of Bangladesh is being held at Bangladesh Shilpakala Academy in Dhaka. The long festival will feature theater and puppet shows by 8 troupes from 7 countries. Next, let's see sports news. In gymnastics, India's Pranati Noyer clinched a bronze medal in the ballet event at the Senior Asian Artistic Championship in Ulaanbaatar, Mongolia. The 23-year-old from West Bengal, who had qualified for ballet finals with 6th place, came up with a score of 13.384 to claim the bronze medal. China's Yu Linming and Japan's Ayaka Shakunji won the gold and silver medal at the event. Keys to remember. In gymnastics, India's Pranati Noyer clinched a bronze medal in the ballet event at the Senior Asian Artistic Championship in Ulaanbaatar, Mongolia. China's Yu Linming and Japan's Ayaka Shakunji won the gold and silver medal at the event. Next, let's see important days. June 21st is celebrated as World Music Day. International Music Day are Fatty De Lam music every year. The first ever music day took place in 1982 in Paris. This move was proposed by French politician Jack Clark and composer Maris Floret to talk about the importance of music. Please to remember, June 21st is celebrated as World Music Day. The first ever music day took place in 1982 in Paris. This move was proposed by French politician Jack Lang and composer Maris Floret to talk about the importance of music.
Next, date 24 June 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. Our Indian government has developed a national strategic plan along with the goal of ending tuberculosis TB by 2025. India accounts for 27.4 lakh estimated new TB cases annually, which is the highest in terms of absolute numbers. Though India ranks 35th in the world in terms of TB cases per lakh people, in the total over 5,62,000 patients were cured last year. Keys to remember, our Indian government has developed a national strategic plan along with the goal of ending tuberculosis by 2025. India has estimated 27.4 lakh for TB cases annually. Next news, a pilot project aimed at providing smoke-free environment in the kitchen for women will be launched by Maharashtra government. The project named Chulla Free Kitchen and Smoke Free Maharashtra will target the women who have not benefited under the Ujwala or any other LPG distribution scheme. Keys to remember, Maharashtra government aimed to launch smoke-free environment in the kitchen for women. This will target the women who have not benefited under the Ujwala or any other LPG distribution scheme. Next news, the government of Jammu and Kashmir have decided to open around 18 Amrit affordable medicines and reliable implants for treatment stores to be put up in all the medical colleges, hospitals and in the most prominent locations which are associated hospitals of these states. The purpose of the initiative is to provide quality and affordable medicine to the end users. Keys to remember, the government of Jammu and Kashmir have planning to open around 18 Amrit stores in all the medical colleges, hospitals and even in the most prominent locations which are associated with hospitals of the states. Next, let us see international news updates. The third Indo-French Cyber Dialogue 2019 was held in Paris, France. To combat the terror in cyberspace, the two sides have decided to develop effective mechanism and coordinate their efforts in cyberspace. Keys to remember, the third Indo-French Cyber Dialogue 2019 was held in Paris, France. It aims to combat the terror in cyberspace. Next, let us see economy news updates. Investment capital in commercial real estate by the investors of Indian in overseas market soared by 92% to $7 million, which is around 4,893 crores in Indian money between the first quarter of 2018 and the first quarter of this year. It is stated by a report. The investors tapped the overseas market to diversify the risk and increase their return, the report by the global property consultant Knight Frank said. Keys to remember, the investors of India in overseas markets soared by 92% to $700 million, which is around 4,893 crores in Indian money between the first quarter of 2018 to 2019. Next, let us see sports news updates. Our Indian women hockey team has won the Japan by 3-4-1 in the clash to win FIH Women's Series Finals. After the lead given by Rani Rumble, Gurjeet Kaur stuck twice. Though our Indian women hockey team has already registered their entry in FIH Olympic Qualifiers 2019. Case to remember, our Indian women hockey team has won the Japan by 3-4-1 in the clash to win FIH women's final series. Case to remember, our Indian women hockey team has won Japan by 3-4-1 in the clash to win FIH women's series finals. Though our Indian women hockey team has already registered their entry for the FIH Olympic qualifiers 2019. Next, let us see important days. 23rd June is observed as World Olympic Day, which was introduced on 1948 to commemorate the launch day of modern Olympic Games on 23rd June 1894 at the Sorbonne in Paris. The first ever Olympic Day was celebrated on 23rd June by 9 nations. Keys to remember, 23rd June is observed as World Olympic Day. The first ever Olympic Day was celebrated on June 23rd by 9 nations. Next, date 25th June 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. Government of Madhya Pradesh will run Save Water campaign with the suggestion and involvement of common people. A state level water cell also been constituted. The water cell will prepare a strategy to store water and ensure its modest use, said CM Kamal Nath. Now every work to save water and increase water expenses on will be done with the suggestion and involvement of the people. Keys to remember, Save Water campaign led by Government of Madhya Pradesh. CM Kamal Nath said water cell will prepare a strategy to store water and ensure its modest use. Next news, during 2018 to 2019, the food grains production in the country is estimated at 283.37 million tons. Compared to last 3 years, this is 17.63 million tons higher than the average production. The Agriculture Ministry has reported that the center is implementing for several crops development schemes and program in the state. Case to remember, the food grain production is estimated at 283.37 million tons during 2018 to 2019. This is 17.63 million tons higher than the last 3 years. Next news, Reserve Bank of India Deputy Governor Viral Acharya told that he has quit his role 6 months before his end of his tenure. Case to remember, Viral Acharya quit his role RBI Deputy Governor. Next, let us see international news updates. The UAE has become the first country in the Gulf of launch GoAML, a new anti-money laundering reporting platform developed by United Nations Office on Drug and Crime to grab organized crimes. Keys to remember, the UAE has become the first country in the Gulf of launch GoAML, a new anti-money laundering reporting platform by UN. Next, let us see appointments. Candidate Mohamed Aoud Ghazouani is backed by Mauritania's government as he won the presidential election. He is declared as a winner with 52% of the vote by the Electoral Commission. His nearest rival, anti-slavery campaigner Biram Da Abid, came second with 18.58%. Keys to remember, Mohamed Aoud Ghazouani won the presidential election. He won with 52% of the votes. Next, let us see important dates. 23rd June is being celebrated as United Nations Public Service Day all around the world. This day celebrates the values and virtues of public services to the community. It also highlights the contributions of the public service in the development process. Keys to remember, United Nations Public Service Day is being celebrated on 23rd June all over the world. Next, let us see books. On Friday, in the occasion of International Yoga Day, Yoga Guru Baba Ramdev announced that his first official autobiography titled My Life, My Mission is being prepared and will be released in August. The volume is co-authored by senior journalist Uday Mahurkar. Keys to remember, Yoga Guru Baba Ramdev announced his first official autobiography on International Yoga Day. The book titled My Life, My Mission. Next. Date 26th June 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. Department of School Education and Literacy, Ministry of Human Resource Department has recently launched integrated schemes Samagra Siksha for the school education, which will be effective from 2018 to 2019. The self-defense training for girls is under the scheme Samagra Siksha. The scheme is an action by raising of number of crimes against the girls and women in our country. Keys to remember, Samagra Siksha for the school education. It is a self-defense training for girls for raising of crimes against women in the society. Next news, the Bihar government have recently banned the felling of trees for sitting in increased amount of pollution as well as a fatal heat waves. However, trees on the private land can be felled in the absence of a tree protection act in the state Bihar. Keys to remember, the Bihar government have recently banned the felling of trees to take an act on air pollution and fatal heat waves. Next news, the driving license format is planned to be modified by Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. The present driving license to be a smart card type driving license. Ministry of Road Transport and Highways has prescribed a common standard format and a design of the driving license. Keys to remember, the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways have decided to modify the current driving license to a smart card type license. Next, let us see international news updates. The International Olympic Committee have recently opened its 145 million Swiss francs. The new headquarters in Lausanne, Switzerland, which is exactly 125 years after the Olympic Games was received. Keys to remember, the International Olympic Committee has formally opened its 145 million Swiss francs at Switzerland exactly after 125 years. Next, let us see economy news updates. To enhance its relationship across the small and medium enterprises, the State Bank of India is planning to expand its market in Singapore. The SBI has served Singapore retail and corporate sector bank since 2008. The SBI has already have 6 branches and ATM services under ATM Fi network. Keys to remember, to enhance its relationship across the small and medium enterprises, SBI is planning to expand its market in Singapore. Next, let us see sports news updates. In boxing, 7 medals were clutched by India's junior women pugilist, which includes 5 gold. While the team was adjudged the best of its tournament in the Black Forest Cup in Wengelin, Shervingelin, Japan. The honors of the best boxers and compromising players of the tournament claimed by Haryana's Neha and Karnataka's Anju Devi. Keys to remember, the 7 medals were clutched by India's junior women boxing professionals, which includes 5 gold. Next, let us see important days. International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking is observed on 26th June every year as its determination to strengthen the action and cooperation to achieve the goal of an international society free of drug abuse. The theme of International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking 2019 is Health for Justice, Justice for Health. Keys to remember, the International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking is observed on 26th June every year. Theme Health for Justice, Justice for Health.
Next.
Date 27th June 2019. Let us begin with national news updates. Second year in a row, Kerala has retained its top rank in the National Health Index. The report analyzes the overall performance and incremental improvement in all the states. According to the Health Index 2019 released by NITI Aayog, Kerala is a top performer with a score of 74.01 out of 100, followed by Andhra Pradesh with 65.13 and Maharashtra with 63.99. Case to remember, Kerala has retained its top rank in the National Health Index with a score of 74.01, which is followed by Andhra Pradesh with 65.13 and Maharashtra with 63.99. Next news, an Indian Air Force contingent including Sukhoi fighter jets will participate in a joint air exercise Garuda with French Air Force. The Garuda contingent will depart on June 25 and the exercise will take place between July 1 and July 14 in France. Case to remember, IAF contingent including Sukhoi fighter jets will participate in a joint air exercise Garuda with France Air Force. Next news, the RBI launches an application to launch complaint against banks. The NDFCs planned to improve the customer experience in timely redressal of grievances. The Complaint Management System CMS is a software application which aims to facilitate RBI's grievance redressal process. Keys to remember, the RBI launches an application in their site to launch a complaints against banks. Next, let us see appointments. Krishnaswamy Natarajan was appointed as the next Director General of the Indian Coast Guard, replacing Rajendra Singh. K. Natarajan, the second Coast Guard officer to lead the force, would take over on June 30. Keys to remember, Krishnaswamy Natarajan was appointed as the next Director General of the Indian Coast Guards. Next news, Warner Media has chosen head office Warner Bros. And named Anne Sarnoff as its CEO. Anne is the first woman to run the studio in its 76 years history. She currently serves as a president of BBC Studio Americas. Keys to remember, Warner Brothers named Anne Sarnoff as CEO of Warner Media. Anne is the first woman to run the studio. Next, let us see awards. Rachna Kaira of the Tribune has bagged the prestigious Red Ink Award for the Journalist of the Year for her expose during 2018 on the functioning of UIDAI and its other data cache. By running these series of strings, the journalist was able to raise a serious doubts about the claims by the government that the other data stored in UIDAI servers was safe and secure. Case to remember, Rachna Kaira of Tribune has bagged the prestigious Red Ink Award for the Journalist of the Year. She have raised a serious claims that other data was stored in UIDAI server was safe and secure. Next, let us see books. The Bollywood actor Anupam Kher is coming out with his autobiography Lessons Life Taught Me Unknowingly that is set to hit stand on 5th August. Kher, one of the most prolific actors in the Indian film industry, has over 530 films in several languages, both in India and the West, 100 plays and numerous TV shows to his credit. Case to remember, Bollywood actor Anupam Kher is coming out with his autobiography named Lessons Life Taught Me Unknowingly.
Next.
Date 28th June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. Our Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi reached the Japanese city of Osaka to attend the G20 summit. This summit will be an important stepping stone for India towards hosting the G20 summit in 2022, when the country will usher in a new India in the 75th anniversary of independence. Theme of the Osaka summit is Human-Centered Future Society. Keys to remember are Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi reached the Japanese city of Osaka to attend the G20 summit. The theme of G20 2019 is Human-Centered Future Society. Next news, for setting up Center of Inland and Coastal Maritime Technology, a memorandum of agreement was signed between the Ministry of Shipping and IIT Kharagpur. The center will focus on indigenization of ship designing, building and testing. Keys to remember, the memorandum of agreement was signed between the Ministry of Shipping and IIT Kharagpur for setting up the Center for Inland and Coastal Maritime Technology. Next news, the Home Ministry reported that 64 people died and over 1.4 lakh acre crop area affected due to Cyclone Fani in Odisha. There was no loss of human lives in Andhra Pradesh and West Bengal. Cyclone Fani affected three states, namely Odisha, Andhra Pradesh and West Bengal. Keys to remember, 64 people died and over 1.4 lakh acre of crop area affected due to a Cyclone Fani in Odisha, which is reported by Home Ministry. Next news, Rahimatpur police station in Satara district in West Maharashtra has emerged as the state topper in the survey based on the smart policing concept announced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Keys to remember, Rahimatpur police station in Satara district of Western Maharashtra has topped the survey based on smart policing. Next, let us see international news updates. Russian President Vladimir Putin has signed for extending Moscow's embargo on food products from European Union up to 31st December 2020. This is due to Russia's retaliation against sanctions over Ukraine. The decree prohibits a number of imports from various countries for 1 year, which includes agricultural products, raw materials and other food items. Keys to remember, a Russian president have signed for extending Moscow's embargo on food products from European Union up to 31st December 2020. Next, let us see science and tech updates. NASA has confirmed that the Curiosity rover, the NASA's Mars Science Laboratory mission, recently detected the largest amount of methane ever measured during the mission. Curiosity's methane reading came to 21 parts per billion unit by volume. This is thrice the amount it sniffed out during a search in 2013. NASA has confirmed that Curiosity rover have detected the largest amount of methane ever measured during this mission of Mars. Next, let us see appointments. Indian Olympic Association President Narinder Batra was elected as a member of International Olympic Committee. He secured 58 votes out of 62 while 4 votes against him. His election is linked to his function in a National Olympic Committee, that is a president of IOA. Keys to remember, Narinder Batra was elected as a member of International Olympic Committee with 58 votes out of 62. Next news, Punjab Cadre IPS officer Samrat Goyal have been appointed as the new chief of research and analysis wing. Mr. Goyal played a key role in planning the February 2019 Balakot air strikes and the 2016 surgical strikes. Keys to remember, Punjab Cadre IPS officer Samrat Goyal has been appointed as the new chief of research and analysis wings. Next, let us see awards. Vayil Marangal have received the Outstanding Artistic Achievement Award at 22nd Shanghai International Film Festival. The film directed by Vichu Kumar Damodaran. This is the first Indian film to win the major award at the festival. Keys to remember the 22nd Shanghai International Film Festival. Director Vichu Kumar Damodaran received the Outstanding Artistic Achievement Award for the film Vayil Marangal, Trees Under the Sun. Next, let us see important dates. The General Assembly recognizing the need to improve small business access to the microfinance and credit decided to designate 27th June as Micro, Small and Medium-Sized Enterprises Day. Keys to remember, 27th June is observed as Micro, Small and Medium-Sized Enterprises Day. Next, date 29 June 2019. Let us start with national news updates. All panchayats to have broadband connecting by March 2020 government announced by Ravi Shankar Prasad, Union Minister of Electronics and Information Technology. Under the scheme of BharatNet project for implementing the project is Ministry of Communication. Keys to remember, from the year 2020 March, our Indian government will protect broadband connectivity to all panchayats. This comes under the scheme BharatNet project. Next news, President ruled for 6 more months in Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir Governor Satyapal Malik. The President rule Article 356. Article 356 President rule had so far been imposed 132 times. Keys to remember, the President will be ruling Jammu and Kashmir for another 6 more months. This rule comes in the Article 356. Next, let us see appointments. P.V. Acharya sworn in as Manipur Governor. The Nagaland Governor Acharya will serve as Governor of Manipur as an additional charge. The Chief of Manipur, Yen Biren Singh, Capital of Manipur, Imphal, Manipur Formation Day, January 21, 1972. Keys to remember, A.B. Acharya sworn as Manipur's new governor. Acharya is already serving as a governor of Nagaland. Next, let us see awards. Indian women crowned as Miss Universe Australia. India born Priya Serao has won the Miss Universe Australia title for 2019. Australia capital Canberra, currency Australian dollar. Keys to remember, Priya Serao, the Indian woman crowned as Miss Universe Australia 2019. Next, let us see sports news updates. Virat Kohli becomes the fastest cricketer to score 20,000 international runs. He took 417 innings to reach the milestone. Keys to remember, Virat Kohli becomes the fastest cricketer to score 20,000 international runs. Next, let us see important dates. June 26 is an international day in support of victims of torture. On 26 June 1987, the UN Convention Against Torture and Other Cruel, Inhuman or Punishment came into an effect. Keys to remember, June 26 is observed as International Day in support of victims of torture. Next.
Day 13 June 2019. Let us begin with Tamil Nadu news update. The government of Tamil Nadu appointed K. Shanmugam as Chief Secretary of Tamil Nadu government. Recommendation given by UPSC Empanelment Committee. The state government appointed with the approval of Governor Banwarilal Brohit. Mr. Shanmugam, the State Finance Secretary for past 9 years. Keys to remember, the government of Tamil Nadu appointed K. Shanmugam as Chief Secretary of Tamil Nadu government. Next, let's see national news. One Nation, One Ration Card from July 1, 2020. A. Will allow probability of food security benefits will be available across the country from July 1, 2020. National Food Security Act 2013 scheme implemented by Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution.
Keys to remember. One Nation, One Ration Card from July 1, 2017. A. Will allow probability of good security benefits will be available across the country from July 1, 2020. Next news. Go Tribal Campaign was launched by Union Ministry of Tribal Affairs and Tribal Cooperative Marketing Development Federation of India in association with Amazon Global. Organizer Traffic objective to create awareness and promotive tribal arts and craft as well as helping in socio-economic welfare of more than 700 Indian tribes. Association partner Amazon Global. Keys to remember. The Union Ministry of Tribal Affairs and Tribal Cooperative Marketing Development Federation of India in association with Amazon Global. Next, let's see international news. The China's Defense Ministry confirmed the test firing of new submarine launched ballistic missile. It was launched from Bohe Sea flew several thousand miles to a missile impact range in western China. Codename JL-3 is one of the People's Liberation Army most secret military programs. Keys to remember. The China's Defense Ministry confirmed the test firing of new submarine launched ballistic missiles.
Next, appointment. J.K. Tirupathi is new DGP of Tamil Nadu. Jared K. Tirupathi, a 1985 batch IPS officer, will take charge as the new Director General of Police, one head of police force. He also received an of police medal for dynamic service conferred by the President.
Next, book release. A book titled A Prime Minister to Remember Memories of a Military Chief, authored by former Navy Chief Admiral Sushil Kumar. This book is about former Prime Minister of India late Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Keys to remember. A book titled A Prime Minister to Remember Memories of a Military Chief. Next, sports. Rahul Dravid to take charge as NCA head of cricket, appointed by BCCI, National Cricket Academy, headquarters Bangalore. Now Rahul Dravid is head coach of India A and India U19 terms. Keys to remember. Rahul Dravid to take charge as NCA's head of cricket. Next, important days. June 29, National Statistics Day. This day celebrated by the birth anniversary of Professor P.C. Mohanlal Nehru, the Sustainable Development Goals. Keys to remember. June 29, National Statistics Day.
To have a daily current affairs updates, subscribe to Vision Academy and don't forget to press the bell button below. And if you think the video is informative, like this video, share this video, comment below for the doubts.